Would you ever buy something that you didn't see? See, imagine you're looking for a car. Yeah, of course you can go online and see all the photos, scroll through everything. But at some point you want to actually see the car. It's the same thing with software.
Whoa there. Have you done your discovery yet? Demos come after discovery. How are you going to help your customers if you don't even know where they're hurting? No discovery, no demo.
A product demo is when you're showing off your product. Buyer's interested, they want to check it out. It's time to show them instead of explain it to them and get them excited about what you're offering.
Demos are all about preparation. Once you've got the meeting in the books, it's time to do a little research.
You'll be so surprised at how much you can forget in just a few days. So always go back, watch the recording of previous calls, go back and look at your notes or the recap email that you sent to the client so you can remind yourself of the key pain points and also their criteria when it comes to looking at a new solution.
Now it's time to deal with the new people you're about to meet.
When it comes to demos, you're almost always going to have new attendees, new stakeholders joining that call.
People are going to bring in others from different departments, different teams to take a look at it.
As you see those people get added to the calendar invite, you're going to want to reach out to them and find out what matters most to them. And then make sure you add what they tell you is important to them to your agenda for the demo.
The other thing you want to consider is creating a recap slide.
One of the few times a slide or two can be really helpful is before you start showing the solution, put up a recap slide. Show everyone what you've learned so far and lay out what you think might be the facts, the problems, the challenges, the criteria that they've set out, and then allow the attendees to add to that or disagree with that.
This is garbage.
The worst thing you want to do is go into a demo with misalignment on the attendees.
And then you want to customize your demo so the client pictures themselves using the solution.
Is what you're showing the customer even relevant to what they're trying to achieve? Or are you just doing this out-of-the-box demo that was built for another customer a few weeks ago, but hey, you didn't have time to put together something that was really going to be super relevant for their business? That's not the formula.
If I'm an airline, I want to hear about passengers. If I'm a SaaS company, I want to hear about users. If I'm a lawyer, I want to hear about clients. You have to use the language that the buyer understands. Otherwise, it goes right over their head.
They're not buying a piece of technology. They're buying an outcome. So if you can't demonstrate that based on what they've shared with you, then you're not proving to them that you're able to help them achieve that.
Look on their website. Find a couple of their key customers. Include those names in your demo. Look at some industry figures and include those types of numbers and metrics in your solution.
Don't expect them to translate what you're showing to their business.
And with all those pieces in place, you're gonna wanna set some time aside to rehearse.
Long demos are a recipe for disaster. Instead, memorize your mouse movements and where you're gonna click and practice them with your team. This will mean that when you actually show up in front of the client, you can just focus on presenting with the best tone and saying the right things and asking the best questions.
All right, champ, the day has finally come. It's time to do this thing. Oh wait, Will wants to add something. Come on, Will, you're ruining our excitement here.
Before the demo, you're gonna wanna prepare to make sure there are gonna be no distractions. One of the biggest ones I see, having tons of browser tabs open. This is so distracting when you start sharing your screen and the prospect's gonna wanna try and read every single tab you have open. The second thing, notifications. Slack, email, LinkedIn. You don't want anything popping up on your screen or making a ding during your demo. It's gonna throw you off your game and it might even irritate your prospects.
Okay, Will, let's do this. The meeting is starting.
If it's a heavily attended demo, there's no way to know who's gonna show up first, if people are gonna be late. If one person joins a long time before everyone else, it can be a little bit awkward if you have nothing to talk about. So look up on their LinkedIn and find one interesting fact about each of the attendees. That way, no matter who joins, you've got something to talk about while you wait for the rest of the people to join so you can start the presentation.
It's really important in the first like 2 minutes of the demo to let people know I do this all day. Like I'm the master of this. So let me handle it. Let's start like this. Intro myself. Let you know what the agenda is today, because who's the responsibility on? This is just one meeting that they have in their week, and then everything else is related to their job. Or you, who does this every single day. You have to take full ownership in the demonstration. You can't expect your buyer to come prepared. You can't expect your buyer to articulate what they need. You can't expect the buyer to know what the process is like. Assume they don't.
Any good demo is gonna start with an agenda setting, right?
A really good agenda might be something like this: confirming the time so that you know what's going on, confirming who's involved from their side, and letting anybody who's new to the conversation make their introduction, confirming what they care about. Here's how we got here. Person X at your company came to me and said, these are some of the challenges you guys are facing. They told me that these challenges are costing your business or causing problems in this manner.
this is a great time to show your recap slide.
And typically in that recap, it's their overarching goals and objectives and why we're even talking today.
This is a great opportunity to do some more discovery, especially with those new stakeholders who might care about slightly different things.
You get to ask them, would you make any changes to that before we start? Is it okay then if I spend the demonstration talking about how those things could be addressed using our product? And that's how you want to guide the conversation again. That builds such confidence. It's like, okay, this person's clearly informed about my business. They've clearly done research. They know who's involved in this conversation, and they're going to address things that we really care about. I'm ready to lean in versus like turn over and start checking my email while this person talks.
From there, we go to the demo. And within that, you have to be really aware of what you're showing that customer.
I need a compelling story, something that's provocative, that's gonna get people to wanna make the change. And the key to the demo is to focus on that emotional pain, because you can get lost in your product. You can get lost in features and functionality. That's not what people buy. There's always an intent behind. You have to think about that. Like, what is the context to them looking at this thing? Because I view this thing all day, this demonstration. This is the first time for them to see it at the end of the day. It's very easy to talk features. You can go to any website and see their list of features, but the use cases and the explanation, how it relates to my business and why I should care about it. It's your responsibility as a seller. You gotta come with that.
If you show features without tying them to a clear outcome for the prospect, your demo is likely to fall flat.
You have a limited amount of time, and the worst thing you could do is spend that time talking about something they don't care about. If the demonstration is just one way of you talking the entire time, you won't find out what that thing is. That's why you have to constantly check in, constantly pressure test your buyer to be like, what is it that you care about? Did I nail it? Is this what you're looking at? Or was it something different?
There is a lot to be said about excitement in your voice and inflection and things like that. So when there's one part of a demo where I really, really want people to listen to me, I kind of slow down my voice. I start enunciating and making things very bold, if you will. I find that I start drawing people's attention back to what I'm really trying to show them if it's a super important part of the demo.
I have certain magic moments in the demo where I'm like, this should hit hard. They should feel pumped when I show them this. If they don't react the way I want, I'm stopping and trying to understand why. So there will be times in the demo where I'm like, so what do you think of that? And I wanna hear something like, wow, oh my God, I've not seen that before. That's crazy. When I hear things like, that's pretty cool, I'm gonna stop and be like, wait, I think you gotta give me more than that. Normally when I show this to people, the reaction I get is unbelievable. Sometimes people fall out of their chair. Yours was way more tame than that. Did I miss the mark? Is this not what you were looking for? Does this not address XYZ? I want to dig in deep.
You'll also want to call out when you see people drifting off.
So just stop. I mean, literally, silence is golden. Just stop talking for a second and look directly into the camera and see what happens. 3 seconds pass and all of a sudden they're going to look up and realize you stopped talking. And then you get to ask them a fair question.
Hey, Sam, how do you think this feature could potentially benefit you in your role today? Kind of call them out, get their attention back. There's nothing wrong with doing that. Sometimes they might say, oh, can you show me that again? And then you have another opportunity to make an impact real quick.
You'd be surprised when you're that candid with people, the way they respond. The worst thing you could do is waste your time thinking you're selling when really you're just like hot air out of your mouth, wasting your energy. That buyer's not gonna buy if they're distracted. So you gotta get their intention. You have to.
Do not waste your time on people who are not interested in you. I promise you, just having a meeting with someone on the books doesn't mean that that's a productive use of your time.
One thing I learned very early in my sales career is not to demo alone. It's really good to have a co-pilot, because the reality is most demos are done virtually. You want somebody watching the faces of the crowd while you're kind of watching your own screen doing the demo. It's really hard to do both at the same time.
Having another person on your team on the call can often help level the playing field. The worst thing that can happen is you have 10 people show up from their company and it's just you from yours. One, you're gonna get peppered with questions and you're gonna be exhausted. Two, you might not come across as credible, whereas if you have a second person, like a sales manager or a solution engineer, they can speak to the more technical aspects and the client's gonna be more trusting of two people rather than just one.
What's most important in that agenda that I shared with them earlier, and they already know I'm gonna ask it, is what are the next steps?
So I wanna be like, this is typically what happens. There's some internal discussion that needs to happen. So I'm assuming all of you are gonna go back, schedule a time, talk about this. But let me pause here and see, what do you guys think? How do we proceed? You set up the answer to that question because you sounded informed. And they're like, that's exactly right. We were planning to talk about it internally. The power of a seller is being able to say what a buyer's thinking without them having to say it themselves.
Once the demo is finished, the last step is to send each attendee their own recap email. This is gonna open up a whole lot of multi-threading so you can have lots of conversations on the side and keep each of your new stakeholders engaged. That email is gonna include any new information that's come to light, the confirm next step, and ask them if there's anything else that wasn't included in the demo that they still have questions about.
And that's it. You ran a kick-ass demo by being well-prepared, by customizing your presentation to your stakeholders' needs, even those who you didn't do discovery with, by asking questions and pausing throughout rather than reading a script, and by setting next steps so that your deal doesn't fizzle out. I'm out of here. See you next time.